With just a few days for Parliament to pass the 2023-2024 financial year budget, government tabled corrigenda to the budget before Parliament, which ballooned the budget from 50.9 trillion shillings that was indicated as a ceiling in the second budget call circular to a whopping 52 trillion. This has left MPs skeptical of the new resource envelope.
52 trillion budget. Me as a person of experience in research, looking at the trend, is not realistic. We shall not raise that money. But what we can do is to identify those priorities that are likely to generate more money to the economy, and we put money there.
Currently grappling and taking a bitter pill on our overborrowed money over time. And the moment you take away the borrowed money, it leaves you with a miserable small quantity of discretionary expenditure for service delivery.
Although a corrigenda is meant to provide details or correction of errors and omissions under the draft budget estimates for 2023-2024 that were tabled before Parliament in March, legislators are concerned that it's being abused by government to sneak in new items in the budget, which were not scrutinized by sectoral committees of Parliament.
That we receive a corrigenda and we find a lot of deviation even from the second budget call circular. A corrigenda by law is a correction. Miscoded items, items that are not adding up, there shouldn't be a deviation. A corrigenda has now become a third budget call circular, and this is not acceptable.
According to the revised estimates, items that require an increase in resources include external financing, treasury operations, non-tax revenue, and local revenue. The estimates indicate that the government has provided 244 billion shillings to treasury operations towards reducing government's liability with the central bank. Similarly, after review of external financing profile, the draft allocations to projects have been adjusted to 8 billion shillings from 7.4 billion. The Minister of Tourism, Wildlife and Antiquities has received an additional of 33.3 billion shillings as excess non-tax revenue collected in 2021-2022 financial year.
We'll look at it tomorrow because it's been forwarded to the committee. We haven't discussed it, but what that means is that the demand for expenditures have increased, and the ministry also need to demonstrate the source of revenue for the increased budget amount.
But some legislators are concerned that by ballooning the budget, it gives the government a bigger window to spend more funds without prior approval of Parliament, because the 3% provided by the Public Finance Management Act widens.
It also gives you a quantum, especially for government, over which you can now draw the 3%. Eh? Which 3% government ordinarily goes on to spend without any scrutiny. And that gives them the bigger volumes of money to be now reallocated by themselves.
So that one means you can spend about over 4 trillion shillings without necessarily coming back to Parliament, and that is what we think could explain the dramatic increase in the budget.
The Otuke County Member of Parliament, Paul Omara, has tipped government to adopt wealth tax by imposing a withholding tax of 6% to sale of animals like cows, goats, among others. Omara is concerned that more rich people are into livestock farming and they make huge profits which are not taxed at all.
The demand for government expenditure has gone up. The PSST came from Washington out of the IMF and World Bank's meeting and said there will be no more concessionary loans available because the demands for the dollars in developed countries have gone up.
He believes this is one way to enable government to widen its tax base, as it can fetch government over 500 billion shillings in estimate. In the budget framework paper, the government indicated a budget ceiling of 4.9 trillion shillings, which was received upwards in the second budget call circular to 50.9 trillion and finally to 52 trillion in the corrigenda. URA projects to collect over 29 trillion, moving from the 25 trillion target of the current financial year, which is not likely to be realized given revenue shortfalls that are being reported by the tax collection body. Report compiled by Fred Kajubi for the news.